the effort that it requires isn't something that you're necessarily thinking about in the moment. It's very much something that you've, I think, in all honesty, you decide maybe even months before that day arrives. And to watch Adrian suffer through that in a state where his body is truly breaking down is one of the most, for me, touching and monumental things I've ever witnessed in sport in general. It's beyond comprehension.
Cory summited last year without oxygen. Adrian had to turn back on that occasion. Adrian, what did you learn from that experience that actually helped you in preparing for this time around?
There were really a lot of things that I chose to do differently. I think, you know, from the very beginning when I decided to go back this year and Cory agreed to go with me, you know, I knew I didn't want to just repeat the same mistakes and hope I got luckier this time. And so I changed a lot. I hired a coach and I had a very well-designed training program for 6 months. It was, you know, it took a majority of a full-time job, my training for the 6 months leading up to Everest.
It's all pretty dangerous though, isn't it?
I mean, yeah, it is dangerous. It's very dangerous.
It certainly felt dangerous, you know, and that's not to make it sound too, you know, crazy or anything like that. I mean, the vast majority of time we spend on Everest is not dangerous for us as conservative climbers making good decisions. You're able to manage risk, not be up high on the mountain when there's big storms, things like that.
And we walked past 7 bodies on the route that I counted this year, and that's just part of climbing, but I think it's an important part. The bodies are left there because it's very hard to remove them. And you know, they just remind you that you're playing a game for keeps. And I don't mean that to sound, you know, overly dramatic, but that's just the truth of the matter. So yeah, it is dangerous, the consequences are high, and a lot of people will question, is that worth it? And I think that's, again, a subjective answer. For me, the answer has always been yes. For Adrian, the answer has always been yes. But for other people, no, and that's for them.
I love the role social media played in chronicling your journey throughout via Snapchat, especially including that special moment you make the very top there. For both of you, talk us through it, the importance of connecting with your legions of well-wishers online as well.
Yeah, I mean, I think it's funny, climbing big mountains like this, especially when you think about the risk and everything that it takes, it can feel very, very selfish. You know, and one of the ways that I think we've both been able to get more out of it is by doing this storytelling, by sharing these experiences with as many people as we can at home.
Yeah, for me, it's just a very, very special way to expand, like Adrian said, outside of what we're doing ourselves. And because these activities are uniquely and innately selfish as strictly an activity, but if you can bring people into that experience and give them a broader view of, you know, the planet and what's happening outside of our own little spheres and bubbles, I think it has great value, and I think it has great value to inspire people. And certainly I was very inspired, and I know Adrian was as well, by the engagement that we had. And you know, when I would have a bad day, I'd literally get hundreds of messages saying, "You got this," and that's that's pretty cool. I mean, I remember these, you know, particularly because they are so emotional, but several people reached out and said, "Hey, you guys doing this, like your day yesterday, the fact that you did that, you know, I'm going through my first round of chemo. And I love waking up and I love watching this, and you guys give me sort of the energy to go through that during the day." And to me, the idea that, you know, I'm willfully engaging in the struggle, you know, and it seems kind of stupid, and yet somebody's drawing from that the energy and the inspiration to go and really fight for their lives, is sort of, I mean, that's beyond words. That's truly special.